Morning from Rusty Rhode Island.
So it's September 25th. It's raining out today, so I'm in the garage. Looking at the back of the fuel tank. I've made a simulated pump. You know, look like it's supposed to look like it's a transfer tank. If you ran out of gas out on the road, I could come out and pump some gas into your tank and get you going to the station. This is one of my Gulf service truck. And the good Gulf guy makes sure that you're in a good mood when I back up to give you the fuel, just in case you're cranky. So I lit a fire this morning just to dry out some steel. I'm going to been thinking about what I'm going to put on that fuel tank. And I had some stickers printed out at the local print shop. And they're not stickers, they're just on hard cardboard paper. I cut this one from this because I think this is too new. This would be from the 70s. So just gonna take a little black paint and touch up the edge, and then I think I'm gonna put this and this on the fuel tank. What I'm going to do, though, because the tank is so rough, is mount it to a piece of steel. And then I clear it so it's protected to the weather. But I don't leave them out in the weather. These are just props. I use refrigerator magnets between the... these I just put in the truck, like I say, for props when I'm going to shows and stuff. Gives the effect. A little lucky. She wanted to come in. It's raining out. She just pushed the door open and said, "I'm coming in." So the 48 makes a little puff of smoke when I start it. So there's just under 100,000 miles on this engine. And while I had it out of the, took it out of the Impala, cleaned it, and I put a new timing chain, and I replaced the valve cover gaskets. And when I pulled the plugs out, they didn't look too bad, so I cleaned them and I put them back in. But now I'm going to pull them out and I'm going to examine and see which plug is getting the oil on it from the valve seal leaking. Like I say, when you start it, it's a little puff of smoke, it goes away. You know, you don't notice it driving, but you know, when you stop and go to start again, you get that puff of smoke. So when I'm at the car shows, I don't want to smoke everybody out. I'm going to do the valve seals this winter. Right now, I'm just going to do a little examination. I've used those umbrella type. If you know what they are, they slide over. They have like a clamp, C2C rings around the rubber that keeps it tight. You take the tool and you tap it down around the valve stem. And they work pretty good. And I'll use those. Because, like I say, it's kept somewhere. I'd love to yank this engine out and throw a new motor in, but I don't want to get another $2,000, $2,500 deep into it. It's a good running 305. It just needs a little love and care. You can see the I did a little modification to the air cleaner. I put that second horn on there, and then I used the hubcap to over the top of the air cleaner, and it actually helps because this hood, actually the seam, you know, where it comes together in heavy rains, you end up getting some water through that crack and it gets down on top, so keeps it dry. Little lucky. Better not be biting on my bumper, girl. Oh, don't you bite on my bumper. That's bad, girl. That's bad, girl. Dog loves to chew on everything. I leave her, she'll sit next to the car and chew your valve stem off. Come on, let's go outside. Let's go outside. Let's go. Come on. Come on, go around. Little lucky. Well, you see what's going on here, guys. I just determined that this was too new. I'm just going to cut the Gulf out of it. Paint black the little area, and I'm going to
What I do is I take a little carbon black, very little, and I'll just distort this a little, make it so it's just not so new looking. Where do I get the carbon black? Right out of the wood stove. All right, guys. See what's going on here in Rusty Root Island. Hope you're enjoying your day. It's a rainy day Monday here. I'm going to hang out in my garage and piddle around.